for everything that he's doing in this season. I praise God for keeping us.
Yes,
amen. Yes, Lord. Amen. And I'm not going to be before y'all on y'all. Y'all know I'm not long with it, even a little bit. Like, go on and get up out the way and stuff. Let the Lord have his way.
Amen.
So he can feed me. Hallelujah. I'm going to sing a little bit about this. It was a request, and then I promise you it's not the whole thing. But it's just, it's always been my testimony. Amen.
Amen.
I'm nowhere close to a perfect man, and it takes a supernatural love to even understand that beyond the walls, behind the mask and the confident smile, was a broken man trying to grow up and make life worthwhile. And I know there were times when you probably shouldn't, but I thank you for always loving me. That's all I'm going to sing in that song. Amen. I thank God for loving you on today. Amen. I know I'm not the only one.
Amen.
But I want to talk to you all about what we so many times are. Amen. And so many times, and when I looked in this Bible, it says something different in my Bible. It says the parable of the lost sheep.
All right.
Amen. And you know, y'all know what I'm talking about. You know the prodigal son. Amen. And I know that there are so many times we find ourselves in a situation where we are like the prodigal son.
All right.
For whatever situation and whatever reason it happens, we find ourselves telling God, you know what, I want to do this thing on my own.
All right.
Amen. And I want you to do all this for me in this moment so that I can successfully do all this on my own.
All right.
Amen. There's been times in my own life that I know that I said, God, if you take care of this, then I can handle everything else, thinking that because of the strength that he's given me, that I have the strength to endure the things that I can't even see.
All right.
Amen. But I think because of the fact that, well, I mean, not think, I thought because of the fact that I could see right now and I understood what I needed in that moment, that that was going to be all that I needed come down the road. All
right.
And I found myself faltering away from the beloved.
All right.
And who was my first love? Amen. And a lot of times we don't mean to do it, you know, because we're still in the process of growing. Amen. You, anyone that has children, you know, if you have a son or a daughter, you know that they're forever growing and they'll forever be your baby. So he understands that we're growing, and in the midst of our process of growing, we have to go through some growing pains.
All right.
Amen. Like I said, I'm not going to be with y'all long. Just stay with me for about 5 minutes, and then I'm going to drop y'all off. And I'm going to Luke, the 15th chapter, around about the 11th verse. Amen. And if y'all want to turn there, y'all can. And if you get there, just let me know by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. And it says, a certain man with two sons. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far off country. And there wasted his substance with riotous living. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in the land. And he began to be in want. And when he went to join himself to the citizens of that country, and he sent unto them his fields. And yeah, Luke 15. Luke 15. We start at the 11th verse. I'm at the 15th verse right now.
Okay.
I'm sorry, y'all there?
Yes.
Okay, we got to be here together. Because y'all going to help me with this. 15th chapter, we have the 15th verse. And it says, and he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him unto his fields to feed swine. And when he would fain have filled his belly with the husk that was the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. And I can't read it because my eyes are messing up right now, so I wanted y'all to go on down, but I basically know this entire thing inside and out. I just wanted to go and give y'all a starting point for y'all to go and look back at. Y'all can close y'all Bibles real fast, unless y'all feel it in the spirit to keep on reading. But the thing about it is, later on down, it basically says that he had to eventually go back home.
Right.
Amen. And when he got home, it says, and I'm paraphrasing, that his father met him running excitedly about the fact that his son had come back home. Amen. And it said that his older brother, he got a little bit upset because the father said, we're going to make a feast and we're going to kill the biggest calf in order to feed and feast that my son has returned home. And his brother got jealous. But that ain't what we're talking about right now. We're talking about the fact that so many times we find ourselves as prodigal sons. That we tell God, okay, God, I want you to give me all of this here so that I can go do basically what I want to go do. Because I believe that I'm big and I'm bad enough to do all this stuff.
All right.
Amen. And the thing about it is we forget that when we separate ourselves, that everything's getting cut off. Amen. The reason why he had a want is because he no longer was with the source.
Amen.
Oh, come on, somebody. So when we think about it in the spiritual realm, if we are with God and he gives us food to eat, and he makes sure that everything is accomplished and paid for, and everything that we need, he supplies to us.
Amen.
And we say to the Father, you know, as the son, as your child, I want you to give me my half of what I feel like.
Amen.
What I feel like I deserve. So that I can go do what I want to go do. And then we find ourselves out in a situation and a circumstance, and we wonder why things don't line up the way that we thought that they should have. Amen. I can imagine, because you know this was Jesus talking because it's in red, but I can imagine as the prodigal son, he said, I got all this money with me and I can do this and I can do that. And he probably had never really been in the world because he had always been under the covering of his father.
All right.
Amen. All the while the father knew that this is my son and I know what's in the world.
Amen.
So eventually he's going to have to come back.
Amen.
Amen. And that's just how God does this. He says that I'm going to let you have a little bit. But I'm only going to give you enough to go so far.
Amen.
Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
See, I can imagine that if the Father had given him enough to be self-sufficient, he would have never came to his senses and never went back to repent.
Amen.
Oh, come on, somebody. See, he knew that the son didn't have no sense, Harley, because of the fact that he asked, can I have my portion of the well that never ran dry?
Yes.
Oh, come on, somebody. I want to take away just a little bit from this well that can supply all my needs, just so I can go feel and massage this right here, this flesh thing. Amen. And that's so many times what we do. It doesn't mean that you're committing fornication. It doesn't mean that you're committing all manners of evil. But that anything that separates you from the will of God and separates you from getting in his presence, that's you becoming a part of a son. Amen. And y'all know, I told y'all, God has to work on me a little bit different, because I had the mindset when I was younger, because you heard the people in the church saying, well, don't commit fornication and don't commit adultery and don't do all this thing. But they didn't say don't get in the place where you don't be praying no more.
Amen.
They didn't say nothing about don't get in the place where you ain't fasting and consecrating anymore. And that's a sin as well. But when you're not taught all that stuff, you think that you're okay and you find it. Then you wonder why there's a change in your spirit.
All right.
Am I talking to anybody today?
Yes.
Amen. Amen. And so we think about the fact that God said, and he says to us when we come back to our senses, just as the prodigal son's father did, he said, I'm glad that you're back home. Amen. Because he went out and he spent everything that he had. I believe if I was reading it right, it basically meant that he was eating the stuff that the animals eat in order to get some nourishment to his body.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And so many times we get in that position, but the father was still where he was.
Yeah.
He didn't move. And he didn't leave the son. The son left him.
Amen.
Amen. That's how God is. He still be right there waiting for us. And there's so many times we say, God, why have you left me? God, why did you forsake me? And God said, no, I didn't leave you. I'm still in the same spot where you walked away from me.
Yes.
I still have my arms open wide and I'm willing to give you everything you need, but you have to, what the Bible say, turn.
Come on now. Come on.
From your wicked ways.
Right.
Acknowledge me. Seek my face. Amen. I'm not going to keep on because if anybody's Hellfest, I messed up that verse, that's my behind. Amen. Y'all know that's her favorite verse. But see, the thing about it is that so many times we get in the position and in the circumstance where we think that we have it all together. And we try to do everything on our own. And y'all know, as I said so many times, how can the pot tell the potter how I'm supposed to be? And what's going to happen? We don't know down the road when something is going to happen. We don't know when some stuff is going to run out. But we do know if we stay under the shadow of the Almighty, then we have everything that we need. Amen. So I'm going to write this song down because I know that this ain't one of the messages and it's okay because I want y'all to get this thing as I got it. See, there's some times when we, and I'm talking about in the spirit, when we get separated from, we feel that separation. He began to feel it because he ran out and he had to eat the things that the swines were eating, but we feel a separation in our spirit. Amen. And when you feel that separation, that's a quickening on the inside. And that's the Holy Ghost saying something needs to get right.
Amen.
There's a disconnect somewhere. Amen. And when you have the mindset of God, and when you are a child of God, then you will be optioned to say, you know what, I got to get this thing right now. Because I know I can't be the only one that has been up all night because the Spirit wouldn't let them rest. And I know I ain't the only one that ain't been able to go about a day without it coming to my mind 20,000 times because God is saying you need to get this thing right now.
Right.
So when you're ushered in your spirit,
yes,
you should accept that usher and say, you know what, I'm going to get this right because I remember a time when I didn't have to want for anything. I remember a time when I felt like my prayers meant something and that they were changing some things. I literally felt a change in the atmosphere when I opened up my mouth. If there's a change in your feeling, then that means that there's a disconnect. And somewhere you have become as the prodigal son. I'm not talking about nobody. I'm letting you know what's happening. Amen. Because so many people go along and they don't know what's actually happening. They feel like I'm just waiting for God to elevate me to a new level and I'm just waiting for God to move. And God is saying, I already done moved on your behalf and now it's your turn. This is what God told me. This is because I was in that position. I was saying, well, God, I've been sitting here for so long and I'm trying to figure out why it ain't happening. He said, well, I already answered your prayer. You asked me to teach you how to pray, and then when I taught you how to pray, you stopped praying. He said, you consecrated yourself saying, God, teach me how to love you. And I showed you that you love me by getting in my presence, and you ain't got in my presence for about a week and a half. Oh, come on, somebody. Ain't it funny, Brother Clay, how we will pray for something for so long, and then when we finally get it, we act as though we didn't have to go through nothing to get it. We act like it took us just going to the store to pick it up. We act like anointing just took us going to the store. I think I want some anointing in prayer today. So I'm going to pick this up. I want some anointing in prayer this work. So I'm going to pick this up. No, it's not like that. And that's going to be that. When you pray for something, you don't fast it. You don't put your time into this thing. I suggest that you cherish that thing and keep it on the inside. See, this is being a prodigal son because, see, you're separating yourself from the source. So we have here where he came back. Amen. He came back with the understanding. Come on, somebody.
Because you mean to tell me, I can imagine if it had been me, I would have been thinking about it. You mean to tell me I left further than that. 5-course meals every day. Didn't have to do nothing. You don't have to work.
All right.
I might just be crazy, but I ain't finna give up rest and peace for work. I'm sorry. I'm not finna do it. And I know that all my needs are supplied. I can't imagine myself saying, God, just give me a whoop. Just give me a whoop.
Right.
I'm that person that when I know I'm wrong, I already got whooped by the world, but just go and give me a whooping for your accord.
Okay.
So I feel so bad. Amen. There's some times that we get in our own feelings. There's some times that there's different reasons why we separate ourselves and become a part of a son. You know, you upset because the bills ain't get paid on time, man.
All right.
You upset because that promotion didn't come through and you don't even know if the prophet that told you that was a true prophet.
All right.
Oh, come on, somebody.
Yes.
You don't even know if it was really God saying that you were supposed to get a promotion on that job and God had already tried to give you a promotion at another job, but you said, no, I'm going to stay here because God told me.
All right.
That he was going to give me a promotion on this job. And God said, no, I didn't. I said I was going to give you promotion.
All right.
Promotion means elevation.
All right.
Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
I heard someone tell me, they said, God is going to give you a promotion. I was like, okay, what type of promotion? So I'm thinking it's a job. They was like, no, a promotion in your spirit. See, you gotta listen to what thus saith the Lord. I'm talking about if you listen to a truth. See, God can give you promotion in your own life. Promotion in your walk with him.
Right.
Amen. Because see, if he should give you promotion to pray right and to seek his face, then all those other things will come because you don't know how to pray right. To get that promotion that you need. You don't know how to pray right to get that raise that you need on your job. See, he's not going to give you one thing and then leave you without knowing how to sustain.
All right.
See, because, amen, with promotion comes more responsibility. Which means more stress. So the prayers that you were praying for that other stress, they ain't going to work right here. You're going to have to say some different prayers. Amen. This is being a powerful son. I hope y'all get this because it's so simple, but we so easily do it. And you can be a prodigal son for a day. You can be a prodigal son for a year. But as long as you come to your senses.
Yeah.
As long as you come to your senses and say, God, I'm sorry.
All right, wake up
and come on, auntie. Wake up at some point in time and say, I lost my mind.
Okay.
I done literally lost my entire mind. And I'm dealing with insanity. But as long as you get in that position and say, I'm sorry, and then you repent on top of saying you're sorry. Don't just use your words, but repent to say, I don't want to go back to that no more. I know what that needs to. I know the stress that's behind that. I can't go back that way. Amen. Amen. So like I said, we ain't going to even talk about the hater brother because that, y'all know how that is. Y'all know how people be like, what, she just backslid last week, now she up there singing.
Alright.
Mm-hmm. It was just last week she was cussing her boss out, now she wanna say she's saved. Mm-hmm. You know how they do when you separate. Oh, and then don't let you have been saved. Mm-hmm. She was supposed to be saved, y'all. You know I saw. So we know how they do, so we don't even have to give the enemy any glory. But in that story, we are the prodigal son. We are, and sometimes we find out that we are the lost sheep of Zion. But you can't be lost and lead somebody else to be found. So you gotta find yourself in the midst of where you are and shake yourself and say, I need to get this thing right now.
Yes.
Because as I've said before, one of my biggest fears is for me to get to heaven and God say, yes, you did preach my word. You preached it well. You had anointing. You brought people in. And there they are. But depart from me because I didn't know you. You know, you can be a separate for someone so long that you forget who they are. If we can do that in the natural, don't you think God can do that in the spiritual? You're going to be like, well, God, I talked to you about 10 years ago. No, you talked to me for all about a day. I know you're not. There's a charge that has been put on our lives, and the reason why it's so important is because of the fact that we have to share what we know. We have to share the fact that God is still there waiting for us. And let people know that he never will leave you, nor will he ever forsake you. And it's not him that turns and walk away from us, but it's us that turn and walk away from him. He's in the same position. He's the same God today, yesterday, and forevermore. His word shall not depart. He is still able to do exceedingly and abundantly. He still shall direct your path. He is still the one that loves you when you're motherless, the one that loves you when you're fatherless, and he is still able.
Yes.
He still has the same power. And he is his word.
Yes.
He is his word.
Yes, he
was the same for your mama, your dad. He's going to be the same for your children and your grandchildren. And that's all I ask. That's all I ask. I hope that y'all got something out of it. Because it's so serious.
Yes.
It's so serious. And I find that the serious things are the things that happen so easily without us even acknowledging.
Amen.
We know that we sin every day.
Yes.
We know that we ain't perfect. But see, when God tells you to get up and pray and you don't do it, you have pushed yourself in a prodigal son situation. Now, some situations seem to be worse than others, but when you get that thing right, you are back under the shadow.
Yes, yes.
I'd rather be where he is under his anointing and his protection than to be caught and die. Not be caught dead, but to be caught and die outside of it. That's how serious the thing is. Because, you know, when you're there, he protects you. I'm sure that the son had all the protection in the world. He didn't have to do nothing. He knew the world by way of his father. The world that his father provided. The world that our father provides for us. That's the world that we know. Anything else we are unaccustomed to, and we will not survive. Because it's not our world. That's why people that are in the world cannot survive. People that are of the world, they cannot survive because we are children of God. We are not of. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to leave that thing alone. Somebody put your hands together. Give God a hand up. Our lovely pastor back up, amen, for her closing words, amen.
Hallelujah.
So,
if God sends it,
he's so respectful.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. If anybody need prayer right now, these ministers are here to pray for you. If you need prayer, these ministers are here to pray for you. And we're going to pray for you. We're going to let the speaker do what we do, and we're going to be out of here. But if you need prayer, just come on. We'll pray for you.
Thank you, Lord God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah, Lord.
And strengthen her right now, Father God, from the crown of her head to the very sole of her feet, oh God. That every thought process, oh God, will be all of you, Father God. That everything that she hears, oh God, will be of you in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. That every utterance, oh God, will be all of you and none of her in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Strengthen the family tie, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Teach them how to be the parent that you have called for them to be. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, we thank you right now, Father God. We magnify your name, Father God, because it's well in our soul, oh God. We praise your name right now, Jesus. We glorify you, Father God, for you are the one that's able to do, Father God. You are the one that's able to rebuke and devour in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. And we ask you to restore, oh God, everything that the kingdom world is coming in to try to destroy. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you, Father God, for the growth of her baby, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for the growth in her spirit, oh God. For the elevation in her, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. We magnify your name right now, Jesus. For you alone are worthy, oh God. Hallelujah, Jesus, oh God. We magnify your name right now, Jesus. We surrender